Hi guys, I'm Andrei Chabatarov, Travel Technology Competence Leader at Eltiksoft. And today I'll answer 5 more questions that new travel businesses usually ask me about flight distribution. Let's roll. What is IATA? How to get IATA certification? IATA, or International Air Transport Association, is one of 2 main aviation regulators. The second one is ICAO. While ICAO focuses on technical operations and safety, IATA establishes business standards and takes charge of some airline financial and distribution operations. For instance, IATA oversees baggage handling standards, ticketing, relations with travel agents, things along those lines. When it comes to distribution, IATA certifies travel agents on behalf of airlines. Basically, IATA makes sure that travel agents are trustworthy and can issue tickets to travelers. Does that mean that you have to be IATA certified to distribute flights? Well, the answer is yes and no. You can enroll to get IATA certification, or the second option, partner with some other business that's IATA certified. Let's talk about the first scenario. If you want to get certification, IATA will ask you to provide proof of business operations, your experience and qualifications. They will also check your financials. Your assets must exceed your liabilities. You must be profitable, and you'll have to provide a financial security bond of around $50,000. But keep in mind that the real number differs depending on location from which you operate. For instance, the financial security amount for the UK is £50,000. For some countries, there is no fixed amount and it must be calculated using a formula. You can check details in IATA's Travel Agents Handbook. Check the link in the description below. If you pass financial evaluation and provide the security amount, you'll receive an IATA code as your identification. Also their ID card and access to BSP, an interface for invoicing and payments between agents and airlines. And then you'll be able to ticket your travelers. But you'll have to keep passing IATA annual financial reviews to keep your accreditation valid. But keep in mind that if you're operating from the United States, instead of IATA, you have to get certification from ARC, or Airline Reporting Corporation. This organization certifies travel agents on behalf of airlines in the US. If the requirements bar is too high for you, you can partner with other travel agents or consolidators who are already accredited by IATA, and they can issue tickets for you. But as you have guessed, you also have to pay for that. What are ARC and BSP? There are 2 abbreviations to learn after you've learned IATA: ARC and BSP, Airline Reporting Corporation and Billing and Settlement Plan. What are they and why do they exist? And why am I putting them together? Lots of questions. Okay. BSP is an electronic billing system that comes from IATA. As I explained before, IATA has many faces and many goals. One of them is to represent airlines when dealing with travel agents. IATA vets agents, equips them with neat little certification numbers that allow them to ticket their travelers. Besides that, IATA also takes care of funds settlement. They take money from agents and then they transfer this money to airlines. If they didn't, airlines would have to deal with every single agent out there and manage their disputes, refunds, and other financial operations. Carriers are too busy with their super important activities like making sure that everyone gets home in time. BSP is what makes this happen. Fund settlement, I mean. How does that work? A traveler pays an agent. The agent books a flight via a GDS. The GDS reports to the booking and ticketing to a BSP processing system. BSP sends an agent billing report, and then the agent must remit payments to the BSP clearing bank, once a week usually. The clearing bank will get this money to an airline. And in this case, the agent is the merchant of record. Another scenario is when the airline is the merchant. In this case, when the booking and ticketing happens, BSP sends invoicing data to an airline's bank payment processor, it invoices the traveler's bank, the traveler pays, and the processor sends the money directly to the airline. Agents have access to all their financial operations via BSP Link, an agent's interface to the world of airline payments. Besides, BSP is responsible for settling funds to agents and consolidators as they net those commissions from every transaction. So basically, BSP is a central point of all transactions across full-service airlines. Okay, what's ARC then? Well, ARC is the American equivalent of BSP. It's not owned by IATA, but it represents financial operations of carriers in the US, Puerto Rico, Virgin Islands, and American Samoa. So if you operate as an agent from those locations, you need ARC. Similar to IATA, ARC offers their own certification for travel agents. Can I sell flights without IATA certification? Again, yes and no. Let's start with the no part. Traditional full-service carriers don't accept passengers who aren't ticketed. The ticket is some sort of proof of payment, and only IATA-certified agents can ticket travelers. But don't despair. There are two, or let's say 2.5 ways to bypass certification and still sell flights. First, you can work with airline consolidators. These businesses negotiate net fares or private fares with airlines, acting kinda like wholesalers. Consolidators do have IATA or ARC certification, and when an agent starts working with a GDS, the distribution system will suggest a handful of available consolidators. Agents can get private fares from consolidators, or just use them as ticketing and fulfillment partners. So, how does it work? First, you generate PNR yourself and then send it to a consolidator who tickets this itinerary. The second option is to go with a host travel agency. Host agencies are organizations certified by IATA and ARC. The difference between a consolidator and a host agency is that the latter usually has its own access to a GDS. So an agent working with the host agency would access the GDS via the host's credentials. Eventually, the host agency receives all incentives and commissions, but then this amount is split between the parties. It's a bit easier to work with a host agency, since they also offer a lot of other services beyond flights. But keep in mind that if you decide eventually to get the certification, it will be harder to prove your booking volumes to IATA. And what about this 0.5 option I mentioned? Well, it's simple. Low-cost carriers don't have ticketing and they don't require any certification. So it seems like great news, right? But don't get your hopes up, because LCCs don't like it when somebody else distributes their flights. While available via GDS, it will be harder to earn money with them. How to choose consolidators and host travel agencies? Okay, several key things to look at. Do they have great deals for your target destinations? Both host agencies and consolidators negotiate deals with specific airlines, and you have to look for what works for you and your niche. Usually, they provide lists of preferred suppliers, so check those. If you are going for consolidators' fares, think of the fact that the majority of them distribute private fares, meaning you can sell them, but you can't show them publicly. Airlines hate when you make their private fares public. Think of the ways you are going to market those fares. Will those be added to some travel bundle, or will travelers call you to get those deals? Maybe you would just partner with a consolidator who will ticket your public fares. This is also an option, as consolidators do have certification. So my next point, check with those certifications. If you operate from the US, the agency or a consolidator must be certified by ARC. For the rest of the world, look for IATA certification. This is the bare minimum that will allow you to ticket your passengers. But there are other industry recognition markers, like being members of travel associations and consortiums, ASTA, PATH, Virtuosa, Signature Travel Network, and Assemble Travel Group are reputable organizations that acknowledge new members only after reaching a certain volume of sales. If you see lucrative commissions, make sure that these benefits aren't coming at the cost of support or any other additional fees. Host travel agencies normally offer first-line support services. Look for that option if you don't plan on investing in call centers. And finally, look for businesses that have been around for a while and have established a relationship with airlines, GDSs, and other partners. The larger their sales volumes, the better incentives they get from suppliers, and the better deals you can get your hands on. What is NDC? So the main thing about NDC, or New Distribution Capability, is that it's not new. IATA initiated it back in 2012. With it out of the way, let's figure out what this really is. Today's global distribution systems are the main aggregators of airline services. Most travel agents access flight distribution via GDSs. GDSs have been around for a long time, since the 60s, and they always had this technical connection to airline computer reservation systems. This means there are two issues. First, airlines have always relied on GDSs to do their business. Second, these mechanisms, airline reservation systems and GDSs, hadn't aged well. They were using old data transfer formats and couldn't do a lot of fancy stuff that internet retail can. So airlines decided to change that and introduce new standard of distribution called NDC. NDC means exchanging data via modern XML interfaces. Now the quotation marks are here because XML isn't really modern anymore. But it works better than data standards from the previous century, right? What do these interfaces have to do? First, they must allow airlines to sell directly to agencies bypassing GDSs. This doesn't mean that airlines will leave GDSs for good, because the travel agent market is still there. But it introduces some freedom to airlines and some competition to GDSs, which is great. Second, NDC must have all those retail bells and whistles that other businesses have. Airlines want to show the images of their aircraft, they want to make custom ancillaries and sell them separately from the actual flights, like budget airlines do. They won't allow travelers to choose the services, bag allowances, pick seats, order meals, you got the idea. And this works. Carriers, albeit slowly, but building their new interfaces, and GDSs are trying to innovate and adjust to the new distribution reality. Thank you for watching. Next time I'll answer the questions about hotel distribution. So stay tuned, subscribe if you haven't already, and hit that like button. Bye!